that track just went from really smooth and melodic to intense and abrasive in the span of 4 minutes. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I am Molly and in this video I'm going to be listening to the album Countdown to Extinction by Megadeth. Now this one I'm really curious to check out. So far I've heard two of Megadeth's albums, their second studio album Peace Sells But Who's Buying, and also their fourth album Rest in Peace. And Countdown to Extinction is their fifth album they released 2 years after Rest in Peace. So yeah, I'm very excited to check this one out and see what I'm gonna think of it. Alright, starting this album off is track one, which is called Skin of My Teeth. I like the vocal delivery of this one. There's kind of a playfulness to it. There's almost like an Alice in Chains-esque sort of sludgy quality to this song a little bit that I'm picking up on. I loved that little tone there from the guitar. That was track one, Skin of My Teeth. Certainly an energetic start to this album, that's for sure. There was a sort of playfulness about it that I really liked. Like his vocal delivery, some of the vocals he was doing were just so unique. And the guitars too were kind of bringing that as well. Like they had that weird little sound that they infused on. Just a lot of fun elements they threw onto that track. But moving on is track two, which is called Symphony of Destruction. And I love the heaviness of this beginning with that bass and his vocal delivery, man. Watch people's heads roll. Just like the
the symphony of
it almost sounds like there's some really slight vocal distortion that they're doing, almost like a watery quality they're adding to this track. The song has a really kind of drawn out smoothness to it, which I like. Some echoiness there. That was track two, Symphony of Destruction. Definitely a little bit more pulled in than that first one, Skin of My Teeth. That one kind of had this slowed down, sort of like slowly building up energy to it. And again, with his vocals too, a lot of variety there. Like he's doing a lot of change-ups with his voice. On that one, it just had such a deep denseness to it, which I loved. All right, moving on is track three, which is called Architecture of Aggression. Okay, kind of like that last track, how it started off with that symphonic sound and then that punch of energy came in all of a sudden. I love how his voice went up and down so much, like his inflection changed so dramatically there. Sounds like a cowbell or something that they're ringing here. It's like the sound of a fighter jet or something flying overhead, and then all of a sudden this guitar solo started. Well, that was track three, Architecture of Aggression. Again, that one had sort of a heaviness to it, which I loved. Very bass heavy. And it's interesting too, this is the album following Rest in Peace, and I felt like Rest in Peace definitely brought more of like a punchy, in-your-face rock energy to it. And so far, Countdown to Extinction is kind of bringing more of a grunge, almost snarliness to his voice. I don't know how to describe it. It's just got like this denser, more pulled back sound to it. But moving on to track four is Foreclosure of a Dream. Again, I'm picking up on that vocal distortion. It's like this watery quality that they're infusing on this album. It's giving it a really interesting sound. I love how that guitar, it almost sounds like gunshots, like it's so rapid. And on the last track, we had gunshots at the beginning. It's kind of interesting. They're mimicking that sound with the guitar. I love how he said the answers in the sky, and right then this song became a lot lighter now with this guitar solo going on. It's like the song took flight in a sense. That was cool. That was track four, Foreclosure of a Dream. Sort of an ambience to that one in a way, like especially there on that ending when it just kind of echoed out like that. And that one was definitely a little bit more pulled in with its tone as well. It still had that amazing heaviness though, and he was bringing a sort of snarliness yet again to his vocal delivery. All right, I'm gonna move on to track five, which is called Sweating Bullets.
Meet the real me.
I was not expecting those vocals. There's something very theatrical about this. It almost sounds like it could be part of a musical or something.
Mankind has got to know his limitations.
I love that change up right there, how the song kind of got a little bit slower all of a sudden. Yeah, and then the track starts picking up speed again.
Well, me, it's nice talking to myself. Here I come again!
That was track five, Sweating Bullets. Such an interesting track. I was not expecting a Megadeth song to sound that dramatic and theatrical. It was really cool though. His vocal delivery almost had like this over the top quality to it. And I loved the percussion on that one too. It just had this rapidness to it. It was almost like gunfire. Like it just had this sweeping sound quality to it. But up next is track six, which is called This Was My Life. It's like his vocals were at the edge of a cliff and they just fell off and dived down. Hey, There's almost more of a melodicness to his vocals on this one, but they're still kind of bringing this like snarliness, like a sludginess to it. An abrupt end to that one, but that was track 6, This Was My Life. I really liked how that one was somehow a bit more melodic and soft, but yet there was like this sharp aggression to it at the same time. I love how they're playing up that dynamic so much. Moving on to track 7 is the title track, Countdown to Extinction. I love the tone of this guitar at the beginning here. It's got a really strong clarity to it. Yeah, I like how clear that guitar is, but then his vocals yet again have that distortion to them. It's like this very, very mild muffledness almost. Yeah, they like utilizing those little ambient sections of talking. Well, that was track 7, Countdown to Extinction. I really enjoyed that one. I think the standout for me on that track was just the tone of those instrumentals. Like the bass and the guitars had such an amazing clarity to them. I loved it. And yet again, kind of the theme I'm picking up on with this whole album, a little bit more restrained with its sound. Megadeth is definitely not bringing as much of that intense punchiness to this record as they have to the other two that I've heard. I like it though. It's really making this album have a really strong atmosphere to it. But moving on to track 8 is High Speed Dirt. Was that a gong I just heard? I love how he delivered that line when he said torpedo, and it was almost like something got shot through the sky, like how he drew his vocal out like that. Kind of a strange ending to that one. That was track 8, High Speed Dirt. It's funny, I just made that comment about this record being more restrained and pulled in with its sound, and then that track definitely brought back some of that punchier energy that I'm used to from Megadeth. It had an amazing speediness to it, and his vocal delivery too kind of had this sharper quality, a little bit less kind of pulled down and sludgy with its sound. All right, up next is track 9, which is called Psychotron. Man, I love that bass. It's really shining through on this album. Man, these vocals are just so snarly. I don't know how else to describe it. There's almost like a nasally quality to it. Like they have this really pulled in kind of creepy tone to them. Yeah, and then that muffledness is still there, and you kind of have this echoiness too. Very atmospheric track. Psychotron. That was track 9, Psychotron. Yeah, again, a really interesting one, how it started and ended with, it almost sounded like a camera or something, like a shutter from a camera going off. Just a really unique sound, and then the track itself had some funky stuff going on with those vocals, like how they would pull it in and make it really atmospheric at times, but then it had a really strong clarity with other elements going on too, like with the instrumentals, they brought more of a clear tone to it. But moving on to track 10 is Captive Honor.
Madness comes, madness goes. Just breaking them in. Quickest way, yeah, quickest relief wins. Never betray, cease to speak or cease to breathe.
I just love how this track is like simultaneously really soft and almost gentle, but then there's such a seething delivery to his vocals too.
Fine. Defendant guilty on all counts. Incarcerated with no possibility of parole. I ain't got a life.
Boy, your soul better belong to Jesus.
Again, there's such a theatricality to this song, a sort of humor to it as well. There's almost like an abrasiveness to this sound, like such an intense squeakiness sort of from the guitar. That was track 10, Captive Honor. That track just went from really smooth and melodic to intense and abrasive in the span of 4 minutes. I really liked how they changed it up like that. It just took such a tone change throughout that whole track. Again, they brought a lot of that theatricality element to that one, almost like it could have been part of a soundtrack for a play or something. And then toward the end there, yeah, that guitar just brought so much intensity to it. I really liked it. It took a turn that I wasn't expecting. All right, moving on to the final song on Countdown to Extinction is track 11 called Ashes in Your Mouth. I love that boingy sound coming through from the bass. Yeah, it's almost like he's over-enunciating his words on this album. It's lending this sort of over-the-top theatricality to its tone. This song is so aggressive all of a sudden. Okay, this song is bringing that punchiness, for sure. This is more in line with the two previous Megadeth albums that I've heard. Well, that was track 11, Ashes in Your Mouth. I loved the ending there with the way they did that percussion, how it faded out like that. And I loved the energy of that track, such a rapidness to it, like an intensity to the delivery. Those instrumentals just went crazy there. I loved the tone of them too, but I thought it was a great way to end that album, just on such a whirlwind of sound. Well, that concludes my reaction to Countdown to Extinction, the fifth studio album from Megadeth. This was a really unexpected listen for me. I enjoyed it. They brought a very strong theatrical tone to this one. They kind of pulled it in a little bit too, made it a little bit more restrained, and they brought a lot of denseness and sort of a sludginess to this album as well. Track 2, Symphony of Destruction, was definitely a standout for me. That one, I really liked how it started off with that symphonic beginning, and then they just brought in so much heaviness with the vocals and everything. And also track 3, Architecture of Aggression, for the same reason. I loved the heaviness of that one. But definitely let me know if you want me to continue on with Megadeth's discography. I know I've kind of been going out of order. I've heard their second and fourth and now their fifth albums. So let me know where you want me to go from here. And yeah, as usual, thank you all so much for watching. Stay tuned and I will see you in the next video.